First of all, I want to thank Jeannie and Bill.
Where's Bill?
Thank you very much for hosting this, and Lori and Ben. And you know, when I ask myself, we have a background, so I'm Minister of Education and Minister of Diaspora Affairs, so basically Minister of the Jews. I'm your minister. Short story, my parents grew up both in San Francisco, went to Berkeley in the 60s, were totally detached from Judaism, not even Reform, all right? So almost no connection. My dad was in the Peace Corps, and they were in Springfield, Massachusetts, working there, I don't know, painting houses and stuff like that. And then the Six-Day War, the buildup started, and it seemed that this little new country was about to be wiped off Earth. And then somehow, my Abba and Ima, especially my dad, became obsessed with this, even though they had no prior connection. And you know, we're next to the big radio, following what's going on. Right after the war, they came to volunteer on a kibbutz in Israel, and thereafter made Aliyah, and in a very, very long process, got closer to Judaism. Interestingly, the big leaps towards Judaism didn't happen in Israel. They happened when they were on shichut, on a mission of the Technion in Canada. They wanted to send their kids just to have Hebrew, so they looked for a Jewish school. And then I came home with tzitzit and a big yarmulke, and I said to my dad, why aren't you wearing a yarmulke? And that sort of triggered the process, which is interesting, because I think that this project, JWRP, has immense potential for the women and the communities and the moms and the families here in America, but also to connect to Israel, so we become more one. And we've got a lot to learn from you. But first I want to talk about the project. You know, the term ROI was mentioned by I believe, Lori. The way I look at things, I call it JROI, Jewish Return on Investment. We've got limited resources. We're doing so many things on campuses and this and Birthright and that. The more I explore and follow this amazing project, the more my conclusion, it's probably the single most effective program in the Jewish world. Still only it's a decade, right? A bit less than a decade, but I'll explain. You know, this week's Parsha, the upcoming Parsha, you know what it's called? Chayei Sarah, the life of Sarah. Now, notice there is no Parsha called Abraham, or the story of Abraham, or Abraham went, or no, there is not. There's only, because ultimately, if you want change, many times it could be a man or a woman. If you want sustainable change, it needs to be the mom. It needs to be the mom. And this is, I'm a huge fan of Birthright, make no mistake, but this project, JWRP, has a few profound differences. The first one there's a multiplier, there's leverage. You get the mom, you get the family, the kids, the grandchildren, you get generations. Secondly, you get the community, and the degree of enthusiasm there—it's contagious. And you have an ongoing follow-up. We don't need to feed the follow-up. It happens. You know, you need the initial follow-up, but thereafter, once it's there, it's there. But there's also something unique about the DNA of the project, and that's because of the founders. There's something very special about you. There's a extra neshama in this project. Something that with all the professionalism that does not exist in Israel, right? it's a full, you know, very professional and measurable, and you get the stats and the feedback and everything's, that's great. But there's the extra neshama that you just, it's either there or not, and we're lucky that in the initial DNA, you know, that once an organization has a DNA, it's there to stay. And I think you can see the way Lori and everyone, and Jin and everyone, everyone, right? And by the way, because it's women, there's no ego. It's all, you praise one woman, immediately Jeannie says, no, it's not me. that's what just happened here. If you didn't notice, Jeannie was thinking, no, I didn't give credit. It's not me. She deflected the credit. That does not happen with men. And I want to tell you, as Minister of Education in Israel and Minister of Diaspora here, and a cabinet member in Israel, you know, if I'm asked what are my top three priorities for the state of Israel, so what is our existence, Iran, etc., we need to deal with that. Second one is internal, we need to strengthen the unity and close opportunity gaps. But the third one, for the state of Israel, is the existence of the Jewish people in the diaspora. And this is new. This was not, typically in Israel, we looked at Jews, especially in America, as either as a wallet or make aliyah. If you're not gonna make aliyah, you're not gonna donate, nice to meet. But it's changed. Israel is strong. We're good. We've got a powerful economy, great, amazing high-tech sector, and on most of the elements, you know, the Arab community is getting part and parcel of Israel in a very healthy way. Still have a lot of work on the Haredi community. That's a longer one, but it's also on a positive trend. So we're strong, and now it's our turn, because the Jews of the world were always there for us. Now it's our turn to be there together. But what I learn, the more I touch diaspora, the more I learn how much we need to import elements from you. And I'll give you another example. My wife, Gilat, she grew up secular. And in Israel, secular is secular. Right? I mean, so she wasn't anti-religion, she just was nothing. She didn't know anything. So we got married. And of course, I wanted to show her how beautiful religion is. So we went to shul, and she didn't like it. She didn't like shul. You know, the shuls in Israel are relatively, I'd say, cold. No one comes up to you and says, hey, I'll show you. Anyway, so she wouldn't come to shul, but fine, anyway. I founded my high-tech company. We had to move to Manhattan, so tough. We had to move for 5 years to Manhattan. Life is tough. One day we're walking on the Upper East Side, and Gilat and myself, about 2 months in, on a Sunday, and we saw, you know, if you're bored, you're fed up with going to the beach, why don't you come to the Beginner's Minyan? Nice little ad, Bill, it's a good ad. So we said, all right, we'll go. The following Shabbos, we went, we walked, it was about 10 blocks from our house. Went up, it was in a school called Ramaz. In a small classroom, there was this nice guy, probably four women, three men, and we said, and this nice guy was explaining the parsha, the tefillah, very slowly for all of us. No questions asked, no one looked how long my wife's sleeve was, it was pretty short. And you were just welcome, because you're a Jew, you're just welcome, period. No one said, what are you, what do you believe in, what color is your yarmulke, is it black, is it knitted, is it black and knitted? And that's something that I think we need to import from America, from Jews in the diaspora. We need that so much, because in Israel, one of our big faults is that everyone is categorized and placed in a very, very specific drawer. All right, so you know, you see this kippah, it means everything. You know already, no, but it's not. So my point is, it's not Israel giving, it's Israel and the Jews being together and learning from each other. So, you know, I saw the movie, I meet the some of the groups that come over. Every time I'm blown away. It's amazing. What you've done in a very short time span is simply remarkable. And it was the easiest thing for me in the world to decide, yeah, we want to join this. We, the State of Israel, want to invest in this. Even though there's hundreds of great projects, this is the project that we need. And I think the method here is they're always trying out new stuff, right? They're trying out the husband thing, and now the educators, and we don't know. It might succeed, and that's okay. I view it like a ship that sends out these small speed boats, and you try it out. If it works, great. If it doesn't, you discontinue it. That's okay. But this is good DNA of this of the group. It's a DNA that, you know, sort of the Amazon of the Jewish world, right? Good day, you've got the right stuff. So on behalf of the government, we're behind you. Aaron, come. I have a special gift for Bill and Jeannie. It is actually a special gift. This is an original coin from 2,000 years ago.
Wow. Yep.
And it was discovered on the southern, on the southern wall of the ancient city. In Hebrew it says, for freedom of Zion, the Chut Zion. And, you know, Jews were doing business back then. That's what we do. So, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Amazing project. We're in for the long haul, and I hope you guys are also. Thank you very much.